Sheriff's office, stop. Get on the ground now or I will shoot. Shots fired. Alright guys, welcome to tonight's patrol. Well, first off, welcome back to everyone after the short break regarding the PC branch. Yeah, I'm looking forward to a good patrol tonight, and we'll see what it has to offer. So for tonight, we have two deputies and approximately four CVs, one rescue. Hopefully, a little bit more people start getting here shortly. So if you do see that, just shoot him an invite, we'll go from there. Administrator, what is he?
nothing really much except for everyone, welcome back, and so on and so forth.
Alrighty. Administrator Taser?
Nope.
Alright. Alright guys, so that's pretty much it. Let's head out there. Let's have fun, safe patrol. Sir, protect, be safe. Salute. Driver, pull the vehicle side of the road. One one 1011 on a red 4-door station wagon, do log at Toledo Bay. 136.
136, go ahead.
Can I have Archie code 2 to back 101? It's going to be in reference to a 1011. Do log at Toledo Bay, one block north from the ammunition.
2-4.
Driver, turn the vehicle off.
Turn the vehicle off. 3-6. I'll see.
Hey, partner.
Hey.
Alright, so pulling this guy over for the tinted windows. Obviously, I'm not sure of how much occupants is inside, so for roster safety, I just requested for a second unit.
Alright, yep, yeah, I got your cover.
Alrighty. Hi, sir, how's it going? Sir, is there anyone in the back of your vehicle?
No.
Okay. Alright, Sheriff Susan Keiko with the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Office. Could I have your license, registration, proof, insurance, please?
Yep. Let me, it's in the back.
Alright, thank you, sir. The reason why I'm stopping is in regards to your tinted windows. Seems like a nice little car you got here.
Why, thank you.
Alright, have you consumed any alcohol in the past 24 hours?
No, I don't drink.
Okay, and there's anything illegal on you in the vehicle?
Nope.
Alright, where are you heading to tonight, if you don't mind me asking?
Actually, I'm going to the buyer that's selling, or I'm selling my car, and actually...
Where's that at?
Well, at LSC. Los Santos Custom.
Okay, so just stop the road?
Yeah, pretty much.
Alright. Alright, just go and hang tight. I'll be right back with you, okay? Alright, sir. Here's your details back. I'm basically just going to be letting off with a warning. If you are heading to the garage, just see about getting the windows removed, okay?
Okay.
Alright, sir. You have a nice day. Make sure you don't go too fast in this thing. Alright, Corporal, thanks.
Do you want me 10-8 or a civvy?
10-8, please. Can you believe it? Oh, shoot. 101, shots fired at my 1020. It's gonna be the, Globe Oil gas station. I have an individual taking off, Caucasian male. Sheriff's office, stop, get on the ground.
136, be advised, I'm... Sheriff's office, get on the ground!
He's running around back. Lost eyes. Oh, he's right there, okay.
He's running onto the other side of the road. I'm gonna get back in time.
Ten four, 136, 1020, direction travel.
Be advised, I have visual on suspect. I'm in pursuit of him now. He's heading northbound, just down the main road here. Great Ocean Highway. He's now back in the alley, just behind the closed door. Going back to the other side. Gotta meet him around on the other side. I can't get through here.
10-4 advised, did you say he went back in the alley?
Yeah. Lost visual.
Do we have a description?
I know he could be a black or white individual with a big white shirt on. Didn't catch the pants.
10-4, 101 if possible, let's get Air 1 up. We need to canvas this area. I believe the suspect was a Caucasian male, shaggy hair with a white shirt and jeans. 101 advised the suspect description was a Caucasian male, shaggy hair, believed to be brown, white shirt and jeans, unknown direction of travel. He was armed with a silenced weapon, believe it was a shotgun.
Oh, 136, be advised. I have an individual throwing Molotovs. Be advised, I believe suspect has just fell off the cliff. Checking it out. My location is going to be just near the cliffside.
Rescue 21 10-8.
10-4 rescue 21 to standby for call. 10-4 136 101 to 136 direct. Advise, I'm going to be trying to flank him on the other side. If you could keep calling the 1020 direction travel.
Yeah, it looks like he's heading northbound, just below the cliff. I kind of lost visual.
10-4. 157, are you 10-8 at this time?
Negative at this time.
10-4.
Be advised. Suspect has just got into a green car heading northbound. Lost visual suspect.
10-20.
He's gonna be behind the last one of those customs on the road back there.
If you guys don't mind, could you steer clear of the police station and fleet away for me?
Be advised, a visual suspect. He's driving a green unknown vehicle.
Advise, seems like he's gonna hit the cliff. A 10-15.
Oh!
For bail.
Suspect's jump.
Sheriff's office, stop. Get on the ground now or I will shoot. Shots fired. 101, officer hit. Drop the gun.
Yeah, if you guys don't mind, I need everybody like away from the police station if it's possible.
Suspect down.
Affirmative. 101, roll medics in accordance to my 1020. Rescue 21, ambulance request that last 1020 officer hit. It's gonna be westbound Pluto Bay by the beach.
Was it the same individual?
Not sure. Seems like he had different clothing.
He was rescue 21 inbound.
911.
911 operator, do you fire Mr. Police?
Police.
Okay, so what's the nature of emergency?
So, I recently bought... 157. The Bayview Lodge, and it's, on Toledo Forest Road, and I, or one of my guests actually pointed out that the sand below, like, on the beach is, like, kind of full of...
10-4 semi.
And, I tried talking to the last owner, and they won't talk back, they won't say anything.
Okay, so you're advising that there's cat litter on the,
yeah, like, the whole beach is full.
Okay, sir. Alright, we're gonna interrupt a officer or deputy to speak with you momentarily, okay?
Thank you.
Hey, sir, how's it going?
Pretty crappy.
Pretty crappy? Alright, what's going on?
Well, so I recently bought this Bayview Lodge, and, I didn't really pay attention to the sand.
Yeah.
But one of my guests pointed out to me that it's not sand down there, it's just kitty litter.
Okay. Do you have any residents with cats or anything like that?
No. To be honest, I think it was the recent owner.
The recent owner? What makes you think that?
I don't know. He was hesitant to show me the beach.
157, 1014, 1019, Caucasian male, 5'6", brown. As for the firearm, it's going
to
be negative at this time. We're not showing any records that he does have a permit for it. Okay, sir. Basically, all I could advise is just if the person that's responsible is not here to clean it up, then unfortunately, you know, since you are the manager or whatever it is, I guess that is kind of your responsibility for your guests and stuff like that.
But sir, I don't want animals coming over and going on the kitty litter. It's just going to ruin my beach and ruin my business.
That's completely understandable, sir. If you need to as well, you can set a policy letting the pet owners know that, or even if you need to restrict pets. You know, that's totally within your rights to do, but I'm just saying, unfortunately, it's not going to go away unless someone physically removes it. However, we have this company in the county that's called Pooper Scoopers, so if you want, I could give you their number and you can give them a call. They could come out and do that for you. That's another option.
Okay, because I heard that there's a coyote or wolf in the area.
Okay, sir.
Supposedly, something happened with the porta potty or something. I'm not really sure, but I'm just...
That was good for tonight.
Then for...
I don't want, that to happen with my beach.
Okay, sir. Real quick, do you, know what happened with this fence here? Wait, is that a... 1 second, sir, 1 second. Yeah, sir, do you know what happened to this car?
I don't know. It's been there, actually, for a while.
It's been there for a while? Do you know whose vehicle it is?
No, but it looks like it's turned on.
Doesn't seem like it's been here long.
No, it doesn't. could have sworn that I wasn't here before you came.
Sorry, do you have a lot of surveillance cameras on your property?
Yeah.
You do?
Well, it just shows, the inside bedroom, not bedrooms, that, yeah, I'm totally not, video cameraing, I guess. Well, kind of. It just shows, like, the porch out area and their vehicles.
Hey, sir, step back for me.
Oh, hey, man. Are you my Up and Adam service dude? Okay, okay.
Overflow vehicle first. Over for me.
Well, sir, I don't have any surveillance cameras pointing over here.
Okay, now just a little earlier. Well, actually, I'll get to that in just a second. Just hold on for me. Sir, just hang tight for me, okay?
Thank you, AI. I really appreciate that. Well, you're free to go, Obzi.
Rescue 21, go ahead.
Rescue 21, can I interrupt you? Code 1. Palito Forest by the Bayview Lodge. Deputies reporting a vehicle in a ditch. No occupants believed to be inside. He's going to be on scene supervising at this time.
10-4, can you repeat that?
157 advised. Going to be the Bayview Lodge, Palito Forest. It's going to be Bayview Lodge, Palito Forest. Hey, sir, just come over here for me. So I don't want anything happening to the vehicle, then you getting injured, okay? Just step over here for me. Alright, so we're just gonna have the fire department en route just to take care of the vehicle, get it out of here. Because obviously that doesn't look good for your business. Now, regarding that, can I just quickly ask, so you said you bought the lodge, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So you're now the manager of this lot, or the lodge. Don't hit my car, please. Don't hit my car. 1 second. Excuse me, sir.
Move your car. I was trying to ask you to move your car, but you wouldn't move it.
Okay, sir, I'm here conducting an investigation, alright?
Yes, but you are sort of obstructing, you know, you're in the middle of the whole parking lot.
101 to 157, let's go ahead and move the car so this individual can back the truck out of here.
Thank you.
.136, be on a lookout for a black sports bike. He's been doing some reckless driving.
10-4. Oh my god, did he just get back in his vehicle? Sir, stop the vehicle and get out for me.
It's kind of hot out here, man. I just need some AC.
Okay, sir, I understand that. We'll get you back inside where there's air conditioning in just a minute. But for right now, I just need you to stay out of the vehicle, okay?
Alright.
Alright, just hang tight. Lieutenant, can you come over here?
Rescue 21 on scene.
10-4. Alright, so I responded for a animal complaint. Basically, he advised that he's the new manager of this lounge. He just bought it, and then, and that he knows there's cat litter and stuff. Upon the investigation, I noticed that there was a vehicle stuck in the ditch, so I asked him if he had, by any chance, has any security cameras that could let us know who's responsible, or, you know, if it's someone from this property. Upon talking to him about that, he said something about, while he was acting really suspicious, he said something about having cameras, or he doesn't have cameras in you know, the guest rooms. So
he's snooping around somebody else's car right now.
Hey, sir?
Yeah, I just want to check the number plate.
Alright, can you just do that for a second, please? I don't want you just moving around too much. I want you to just stand right over here, where there's shade, and don't move, okay?
Okay, they didn't actually park in the... This is for authorized personnel only.
Okay, sir, we'll deal with that in just a minute. But like I said, I just need you to step over there, please. Yep, so when I was talking to him, he started freaking out and saying how he didn't put any cameras in, you know, his guest room, so I assume he's probably spying on them or something like that. It's totally an invasion of privacy, so I just want to get some more information on that, kind of figure out what operation he's running here. Rescue?
Yeah, I heard there was a lawsuit filed here about that, like, a couple months ago.
Oh, was there?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what some friends told me. I didn't hear much about it, though.
Alright. Rescue. Basically, there's no one in the car, but we do need to get it out of there, so maybe you're going to have to winch it out. I didn't run it yet, so I'll do that after. Possibly find an owner. Figure out why it's in the ditch.
Alright, dude. Can I get one of you guys to help me with it?
Yep. Hey, Lieutenant. Sorry, since you're... Since you just got here, maybe if you want to take a crack at him, see if he'll tell you anything else that he didn't already tell me, I'll just assist, rescue the car.
Alright,
I'll get the engine, for the time being, can you see if the car's unlocked and,
Yeah, it is unlocked and it's armed.
To it.
Alright, sure thing, just let me know when you hooked it up.
Alright.
Hey, sir, what's going on? Obviously, you know, my partner's already spoken to you, but is there anything you want to, you know, let me know about what's going on here again?
Nothing. Yeah, nothing. Okay, fine. You want to know the truth?
That'd be nice.
Well, so... The last owner gave me this place really cheap. I didn't really know why until I got in here and looked at the security cameras. It showed many cameras in a lot of the guest rooms. I had those taken out. Well, I actually smashed them myself, and I disconnected the wires and everything. And I asked him. He told me not to tell anybody or else he would get in trouble.
Okay, well, you're going to have to do some kind of report about that because that's obviously kind of something you're being... Apparently, you didn't have them taken out in time because I've heard from some friends that have vacationed out in Toledo Bay before that this place was getting a lawsuit on it. So, obviously, you didn't get them taken out until, like,
no.
A little bit in. So you need to obviously file some kind of report about how the previous owner had that going on. So you're not liable for it.
The whole situation was with that owner. I just came in here like about a week ago.
Okay. That makes sense. So you just might want to clear that up.
All right. So I'm just going to run the information and go from there.
So you can just sit tight for me. All right.
Looks like this car is going to be totaled. I'm going to call the towing company to see if they can come take this up and take to the impound lot.
Alright, sure thing. I'm just going to run the information.
Yeah.
Alright. You get anything, Lieutenant?
All I said was that the previous owner had the security cameras in there and that he's removed them. Basically, that's all he basically told me.
That he did remove
them? Pertaining to what's going on. Yeah, he had them removed, yes. That he broke them himself or something and removed every one of them. Something like that.
Okay, it's kind of just suspicious that... Well, first off, regarding the cameras, I mean... I just asked him if he has any, you know, cameras around the building, specifically ones pointing in this direction to see Then he just started freaking out, you know, as if he was doing something wrong. He started saying there was only one pointing there, and then, you know, I mean, I didn't, like, say that there's any in my guest room. You know, he's just stuttering, so. Other than that, I guess, can't really lay any charges on him for right now, based on lack of evidence of who even installed the cameras. So I'm just going to run the information for this vehicle, see who it belongs to, and then we'll go from there, okay?
Alright.
Okay, so I'm just going to be straight up with you. I'm not necessarily sure, nor can I, you know, state for a fact that you are doing what I suspect you're doing, but if you are, you need to stop because that is illegal. It is considered an invasion of privacy, okay? If you did state that your previous owner, or the person that previously owned this lounge, did have cameras and you took them down, that's fine. But just make sure that if there's not any stationed in the rooms, okay? If it's on the outside,
no.
Then that's fine.
No way, man. No. I make sure there's not gonna be anything in there.
Alright, sir. That's good. For this vehicle, we're gonna have a tow company en route momentarily to pick it up, okay? So just go ahead and leave it there. Regarding the parking, I don't see any signs, so I would suspect that your guests don't know either. So it's your job as the owner to enforce all that stuff written. By written or stuff like that, okay?
Totally.
10-4. Alright, sir, you're free to go. Have a good day.
136, be advised. Requesting backup. Sir, get to the ground! Sheriff's office! Requesting additional units at the closed store, Polito Bay. Individuals just. Oh!
136, could you verify the status?
Individual is running around the closed store at the moment. Just hopped on a bike. Looks like he's trying to take off.
10-4. Channel 1 broadcasting. Officer requesting for 1199. It's going to be the closed store, Polito Bay. standby. Advise, he has an individual. Running around the closed store, no further information at this time. Responding units, please verify.
Be advised, suspect is taken off on an orange bike. He's headed down to the northbound, to the beach.
10-4, do we have a suspect description?
Orange sweater. He's on an orange bike. All the information I have at this moment.
10-4.
137, I need an updated 1020.
Gonna be heading southbound on the beach. 10-4, back northbound. 10-4. He's gonna be just behind the customs right now.
10-4 behind his taser. 101 primary direct. What's this guy wanted for?
He struck an individual. I think the individual was knocked out at the closed door. So if we can get ambulance there, that'd be good.
10-4, dispatch to all units, whole radio traffic. Rescue 21, ambulance requested at the closed store, Polito Bay, Polito Boulevard. It's in reference to a victim believed to be unconscious prior to an assault. Deputy is going to be in pursuit of the suspect at this time. We'll update you as it comes.
911.
Oh.
911 operating, fire mess, police.
Well, there's our police officer behind him, but I'm the individual who got struck at the clothing store, and I'm chasing the guy that struck me, or the guys that you guys are in pursuit with right now.
Okay, sir, do me a favor. Do not chase the individual, okay? We already have deputies pursuing him, all right?
Well, 157, frankly, I need a 1020. I have no clue.
Catch up.
Okay, sir, once again, do not pursue the vehicle.
The advised suspect is heading eastbound. down Palito the highway. Correction. He's now on the railroad, heading southbound.
Is this kind
individual
of
looks like. Oh, individual is right in front of you guys.
1-1 has eyes. 157, go ahead and take comms.
157, I don't have visual.
I believe he's last seen heading straight southbound. One one, stand by. I'm gonna be. I think I have eyes affirm. He just entered the passing the motel. Believe he's going in and out of alleys. Lost visual. 1-1, 12 units, stand by. Transitioning to air one when I get the chance. Units, let's go ahead and set up a perimeter.
157's canvassing east towards the closed door.
It looks like he was chasing the suspect for a bit, and then he pulled off, so I think he's alright, but last time I saw him, he was chasing the individual.
10-4. Rescue 21 advised, update regarding that last call. Victim appears to regain consciousness. Unconfirmed if he did seek medical attention at the hospital, however he was conscious.
Be advised, just spotted a vehicle traveling pretty quickly to Los Angeles Customs. Couldn't see if it was a bike or not, but,
Everyone has eyes affirm it's gonna be that vehicle. He's passing the farm at this time, he's stopping. It's Los Angeles County Sheriff's Office, driver stop. Advised, he's underneath the tree, ground unit, watch out, he could be armed. He's taking off again. Everyone's gonna be taking comms, all units hold radio traffic. He's heading back towards the beach. Southbound at this time on the dirt road. He's possibly gonna hit the jump. Standby. Okay, he's on the beach. He's gonna be going underneath the boardwalk at this time, continuing southbound Pacific Ocean.
Watch for fast tonight.
10-4-125, can I interrupt you, code 3 to assist for that pursuit?
10-4, en route.
Los Angeles County Sheriff's Office, driver stopped the vehicle. 10-4, he just sideswiped the vehicle, he's still mobile, southbound, Palito Bay, entering Palito Forest at this time. He's gonna be approaching the, lodge. Okay, just went off-road again, he's heading towards the Sheriff's Office, standby.
136, I'm gonna try to cut him off.
10-4. Standby, Air 1, lost visual. The trees was very thick. Trying to regain at this time.
10-4.
He's last seen somewhere between the police station, correction and sheriff's office, and the lodge. 10-4-157.
God damn it. 157, disregard my list. I'm out.
136, I'm gonna go in the bushes and see if I can see him. Oh, be advised, found his bike. Oh, there he is.
Sheriff's office, get the. Oh, shots fired.
Shots fired.
Units, what's the status?
Suspect's down.
Suspect's down.
10-4. Air 1 to dispatch advised. Suspect is down. Air 1 going to turn the base up.